I'm Gayle Laakmann McDowell, author of Cracking the Coding Interview. Today I'm going to solve the ice cream parlor problem. So in this problem, we're walking to an ice cream shop with a certain amount of money, and we want to spend all of our money and buy exactly two flavors of ice cream. And we want different flavors of ice cream. So we're looking at the menu, and we want to figure out which items do we need to buy. So there's a couple different ways of approaching this, but one thing to just be very clear about here is that we want to return the indices, not just the values themselves. Also, although two different flavors might have the same exact price, we cannot get two of the same flavor. So if we're looking to spend $10 and chocolate and vanilla ice cream are both $5, that's fine, but we can't buy two chocolate ice creams. So we could do this by brute force, just walk through all pairs of ice creams and see if it sums to the right value. That'll be O of n squared though. Alternatively, we can walk through each item and look to see if the complement is contained in that. So when we see strawberry ice cream for $2 and we want to spend $10 total, check to see if there's an 8 anywhere else on the menu. But how do we check for the complement? Well, we can walk through and by brute force and do that. The other thing we can do is we can take everything in the ice cream menu, throw it into a hash set, and then look for the complement each time. Now we have to be a little bit careful there though, because if we see vanilla ice cream for $5, and let's imagine we're in a world where chocolate ice cream does not exist. So we're walking through the menu, we see vanilla ice cream for $5, the complement is 5. If we just looked up 5 in the hash set, it would be in there because we'd be looking up vanilla. So that's actually not a valid solution. So we need to be careful with our hash set that we're actually looking at a different index. Another way we can do it is take this menu, sort all the items, and then check to see, just do a binary search there. Now, the complexity here is that we want in the end to return the indices, not the actual values. So we're gonna have to have some way of, given these values, getting back to the right index. And that's actually not too big of a deal. We can either use some struct that holds both the cost of the menu item as well as the index itself, or just create a copy of the menu. And that's actually the simpler approach and the one we'll take. So let's turn to the code now. So we have this method find choices, and it takes in the menu and the amount of money we're looking for, and then it returns the indices. And we want to return it such that the first index is first. So what we're going to do is actually sort a clone of this. So this is going to be menu.clone, and then we're going to sort to this, do arrays.sort. Sorted menu. So we're going to sort that. And then we're going to walk through each element in the array for I equals 0, I less than menu, sorted menu.length. Doesn't really matter, but sorted menu.length, I plus plus. And then we're going to calculate the complement, which is going to be money minus menu of I. And then we're going to do a binary search on this. So Java actually has a built-in binary search method. So binary search on sorted menu, and we're going to look for complement. Now, one little issue here is we want to make sure that the item we turn up is not actually just the same exact instance of menu of I. So we want to, and in fact, it's a little optimization as well. We can tell it, hey, I already walked through the left chunk of the array. Go only search the remainder. So it's both an optimization and it fixes a bug that we'd otherwise have. So we want to tell this, start from index I plus 1 and then search the remainder of the array. Now in Java, binary search, if the item is not contained, it doesn't return negative 1. It actually returns the value where it would be contained. So we need to make sure that menu of location actually equals the complement. And we're going to want to do some bounds checking here. Location is greater than or equal to 0, and location is less than menu.length. Then we have found our items. Now just go and track down the indices. So indices equals get indices. I'm going to throw this off into another function to keep my code as short and clean as possible. Get indices from values of, I want to make sure I pass in the original menu. And then pass in menu of I and pass in the complement. So go look those up in the original menu, and we get their indices and return those. Otherwise, return indices here. Now, let's talk about get indices from values. So this is going to return an integer array, and it's going to take in the menu, and it's going to take in the two values we're looking for. So we'll start off the kind of first attempt that actually doesn't quite work for kind of subtle reason. So we're going to want to do something like this, an index of walk through and look for value one in menu, index two equals index of menu value two. And then we want to create this indices array that we're going to return, which is going to be math.min index one comma index two. And then math.max, because we want the first index to appear first. And then return indices. And again, there's a little bug here. See if you can figure it out. And so then we take in the menu and the index we're looking for. So actually, I'll just bang this out real quickly. Seems to be very, very simple, right? Walk through and look for the menu. Walk through the menu, look to see if that, actually you want to find, that should be called value, and look through and see if menu of I equals value. So return I, otherwise return negative one. Now there's a little issue here. Imagine we have $10 to spend and vanilla ice cream and chocolate ice cream are both $5. Well, that'll be a valid pair. So complement will go through, menu of I will eventually be five, complement will be 5. The binary search will actually find a different item because we're only starting at I plus 1. And then I'll go all the way up here and we'll say, okay, index of, pass in menu, and then value 1, which is 5. Then we'll do index 2 and say pass in menu, and then value 2, which is still 5. And index 1 and index 2 will give us the same thing. So even though there are two different values that are 5, we're going to get the same index, and that's not what we want. What we really want to say is, hey, don't return index one here. So we want to give it a value to actually exclude. So I'll just do that. Exclude this. And I'll just check that here. And just make sure that I'm not picking the same index again. Very simple. So let me just walk through this and make sure that I got all these variables right. So I have this menu and I'm passing in creating sorted menu. And I should make sure that I'm always using that in the right way. Very, very easy to mix those variables up. So keep that in mind, actually, when you create copies of things, that you're always actually using the copy value when you should. So everything should be sorted menu other than actually the get indices from values. Okay, let me just make sure. Oh, that should be null. So a couple little issues, nothing too big of a deal. In an interview, especially if you're the one who catches it, it's not really a big deal to have a little typo like that. Okay, so now let's go ahead and submit this, make sure it all works. So I've seen a lot of candidates in problems like this where they have, you know, a little issue like, you know, index of needs to skip over a particular value, come up with these much more complex ways of doing it. You know, sometimes the easy approach is fine. Of just saying, okay, well, what I actually need to do is just skip over that index, so just do that. But you don't want to go overboard with that and get super hacky. So it's very much a balancing act, and just talk with your interviewer at the very least about the trade-offs and some different approaches you could take. So keep that in mind and just, you know, be careful of these sort of things. Be careful of, you know, this kind of mistakes I was making here with, you know, misusing the variable that you're supposed to be using. So keep those in mind and good luck.